हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू मॉडलिंग लैब ट्यूटोरियल। कोर्स कोड U18ME309। आई एम बी राकेश, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग, किट्स डब्ल्यू। इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन टूल्स इन कैटिया V5। Now let us see how to choose transformation tools in CATIA V5 and what are the tools available in CATIA V5. In this CATIA V5 software, choose insert menu. In this you can choose operation. In this operation you can choose transformation. It displays six different types of tools. One is mirror, symmetry, translate, rotate, scale, offset. These are the six tools are available in transformation tools in CATIA V5. Now I'm going to explain these six types of tools directly in CATIA V5 software with examples. Start, click start button. In this mechanical design, choose sketcher workbench. In these three different planes, you can choose any one of the plane. I am choosing XY plane. Where you can get transformation tools, just you can go to the insert menu, operation, transformation. This transformation consists of mirror, symmetry, translate, rotate, scale, offset. Now let us briefly discussing about mirror constraint in CATIA V5. How to use mirror constraint in CATIA V5? Okay, what is the use of mirror? Mirror constraint is used to produce the mirror of a model or an object while doing sketching or modeling in any CAD software. This constraint increases the flexibility for the user by providing a similar object to on the other end. First you can draw one sketch. Now I want to draw one sketch by using profile. Okay, this is the one sketch. Okay, I drawn in this sketcher workbench, and also you can draw one axis or line. I want to draw axis here. Axis are reference line. Secondly, whatever the part of the body is to be mirrored is to be selected and choose the mirror option from the menu bar. Now I am choosing mirror option in the insert menu, operation, transformation, mirror. Now choose the object, and secondly you can choose the line or axis. That's it. The same part is displayed on the other side of the axis. This is the procedure to create mirror objects in CATIA V5 software. Insert. Now I want to apply the constraint for this object. Insert constraint, constraint creation, auto constraint. Select two circles. Okay. Now let us discussing about symmetry constraint in CATIA V5 software. Okay, already you know what is symmetry. Symmetric constraints play a vital role in the field of design of model complex structures. With the help of symmetry constraint, a lot of time is being saved while sketching or modeling any complex drawing. Here in this video, I will show you about how to use symmetric constraint in CATIA V5. Symmetric constraint can be used in the cases where there is a need of symmetry in the objects sketched or modeled in CATIA V5. First, you can draw a sketch. Already I drawn the sketch in CATIA. If you want the exact sketch on any other side of the plane, then you can draw one axis or reference line here. And now choose inset, operation, transformation, symmetry. Now choose the object, choose the sketch component. Select the object, inset, operation, transformation, symmetry. And now choose the axis or reference line. Then the component can be shifted to another side of the axis or line mentioned here. You can make the symmetry of the component completely or partially, that is depending upon your selection. Now let us discussing about translating elements. The application provides a powerful command for translating elements. You may either perform a simple translation. Translation means you can move the sketch one place to another place with specific distance, or create several copies of 2D elements. This session I will show you how to translate 2D elements by using duplicate mode and then selecting the element to be duplicated. Just you can click inset menu, operation, transformation, translate. The translation definition dialog box appears. It will remain displayed all along your translation creation. You can see here it shows different options. One is instances, duplicate mode, keep internal constraints, keep external constraints, and also it shows length value. You can see here the duplicate mode option is activated by default, which means that the 2D elements you select will be copied. If you unchecked duplicate mode, the element will be moved. Keep the instances field, that is here default is 1. The duplicate mode option is activated. Select the keep internal constraints. Now I'm choosing keep internal constraints option. The option specify that you want to preserve in the translation the internal constraints apply to the selected elements. The second one is keep external constraints. This is the have deactivated this option, keep external constraint, because in our drawing having only one sketch, that's why I have not unchecked the keep external constraints. Any external constraint existing between the selected elements and the external element will be disregarded in the translation. Now select the elements to be translated using trap selection. Already know how to select the elements. You can select the elements by using mouse You may either select the one 2D element or multi-select the entire 2D geometry by trapping it by using mouse. Now click to indicate. Now click to indicate the translation vector starting point. You can define the translation length in the geometry area using the mouse. For more precise results, enter a specific value for the translation length in the translation definition dialog box. You can directly enter the value here. Now I'm typing 50 in the length field. Just you can click OK. Next, click to indicate the translation vector ending point. This is the starting point. Next, you can click to indicate the translation vector ending point. You can click anywhere. You can notice that the internal constraints were preserved in the translation element. Because we have chosen keep internal constraint dialog box. This is the procedure. If you enter in the space of instances, you can type 3, 4, 5. That is depending upon your requirement, you can enter the value in the instances. In the previous dialog box, I have entered only one, so that's why one duplicate copy is created. Next one is rotating elements. In the rotating element, I will show you how to rotate the elements. In this scenario, the geometry is simply moved, but note that you can also duplicate elements with the rotation command. You can be deactivate the duplicate mode if needed by deactivate duplicate mode. Okay, how to choose rotate option? Just go to the insert menu, operation, transformation, rotate. The rotation definition dialog box displayed and will remain displayed all along the rotation. Deactivate the duplicate mode. Here the duplicate mode is already activated. If not required, you can uncheck the box. If you keep it active, you will be allowed to define the number of the instances you wish to create in the meantime. Now I have unchecked this duplicate mode. Select the geometry. Select geometry to be rotated. I want to select this geometry. You can choose single element or multi element by using trap the mouse. Now select or click the rotation center point, or you can draw one reference line. This is the first point and second point. This is the reference line. Now you can also enter the rotation value. You can also enter the rotation value in the rotation definition. Angle value, you can directly enter the exact value here. I want to enter 45 degrees, 4, 5. Okay, the rotating elements also updated. Rotating elements also means recomputing distance values into angle values if needed. Be careful, only non-fixed elements are updated. The next one is scaling elements. This task, I will show you how to scale an entire profile. In other words, you are going to resize a profile to the dimension you specify. Okay, how to choose scaling element? Go to the insert menu, operation, transformation, scale. You can increase the value. You can first select either the geometry or icon. If you select the icon first, you cannot multi-select the elements. Already you know this point. Now you can select the elements to be scaled. When you choose the scale option, it displays one scale definition dialog box. It shows duplicate mode conservation of the constraint. Now you can click indicate the center point in the geometry. You can define the center point from its coordinates in the sketcher tool. Toolbar fields, you can directly enter the center point here. Otherwise, you can click one point in the geometry. Now, in the scale definition dialog box, you can type one value, that I am choosing 3 as the scale value you want. Click OK. You can see here internal constraints are preserved but revalued. That means the values are increased 3 times. This is the procedure to scaling elements in the Sketcher workbench. The last one is offsetting 2D geometry. I'm going to offset. I want to draw one sketch. Offset means, for example, I want to create one line. Select inset operation, transformation, offset. There are two possibilities, depending on whether the line you want to duplicate by offset is already selected or not. If the line is already selected, you can see here already I selected this line. Next, I have chosen the option. The line to be created appears immediately. If the line is not already selected, select it, the line is to be created appears. Select a point or click where you want to the new element to be located. The selected line is duplicated, both lines are parallel. You can see here, these two lines are parallel. This line is duplicated and these two lines are parallel. If you are offsetting circles, for example, I want to draw a circle. Next, inset operation, transformation, offset. If you were offsetting the circles or arcs, the two circles or arcs would be concentric. This you can click outside or inside. These two circles are concentric. Concentric means the circles having different radius but center is same. If the geometrical constraints and dimensional constraints are active in the sketch toolbar when the offsetting an element, constraints are automatically created based on the type of the element you are offsetting. Thus, if you move an element or change its geometry, the other element will be moved or modified accordingly. Now let us see what are the different tools available in offset tool. Inset operation, transformation, offset. You can see here it displays 4 different tools. One is no propagation, second one tangent propagation, third one point propagation, fourth one both side offset. Now I'm going to explain these 4 different tools in offset command. I'm going to explain these 4 options. I want to draw one sketch. Delete. And first I'm taking one rectangle. Now apply the cornering operation, corner for these 2 edges. I'm taking this example for explaining the four options. Now first I am choosing. The first option is offset. First one is no propagation. Now activate this no propagation. Now I am choosing this curve. Just you can click here. Here one arc is offsetted. Just you can see here another example. Transformation offset. Now I'm choosing only this line. This line. Click here. Okay, already that arc is already selected, so that's why this arc is offsetted. Okay, no problem. Now I want to delete these two lines. Now I'm going to explain second one, inset operation. Transformation offset. Now I'm choosing second one. Second mean to offset an element and elements which are tangent to it. Now I'm selecting tangent propagation. Just you can see here this line and these two lines are tangent. So I'm selecting this curve and click to outside. The offset is created for this curve and these two lines. Next example is inset operation transformation offset. The third one is point propagation. To offset an element using point propagation, now activating this point propagation. Now I am choosing this curve and click to outside. You can see here the entire object is offsetted. You can observe the difference between these previous two commands. The last one is operation transformation offset. The last one is to offset an element symmetrically to another. Now I am activating this option. This is both side offset. Now I am choosing this curve and click to outside. Just you can see here the symmetrically the object is created symmetrically both sides. For example, to offset and duplicate multiple elements, this you can choose inset operation transformation offset. Now I'm choosing last one. Click here. Just you can enter the instances, and now I am entering 3. Click OK. Because the dimension parameter value has not been changed, so that's why you can decrease the value. Three, enter. Four, enter. Two, enter. Okay, just a minute. Inset operation transformation offset. Now I'm choosing the previous one, that is point propagation. Enter the instances, that is 5. Okay. Just you can see here the number of elements you want to create in the instance field. Just you can I enter the 5. You can see here the sketches offset 5 times. 5 objects are created at the outside. This is the procedure to create offset command. I hope this is very clear to everyone. This is the brief discussion with the brief discussion of transformation tools in CATIA V5 software. Okay, thank you for watching. Please do like and subscribe my channel for more updates.